This handshake in the nation's capital signifies more than a symbolic gesture forging a partnership between MTSU and the U.S. Army. It's an historic first-of-its-kind exchange on unmanned aircraft systems in the U.S.
This agreement is another series of bold steps that we've taken to provide the very best facilities, training, and service in this important area.
MTSU President Sidney McPhee and Colonel Timothy Baxter, the Army's project manager for unmanned aircraft systems, inked the memorandum in a formal signing agreement.
I think we all recognize that UAS has broader applications in the future, so this type of partnership can only strengthen and benefit our country in the future.
The unique partnership was announced during the Association for Unmanned Vehicle Systems International Conference in Washington, where Dr. McPhee got a first-hand glimpse of the vast array of new unmanned technologies.
What he's going to demonstrate in a minute, going through doorways, going through that tube right there, is something that's very challenging, even for most multi-rotor devices.
Including this demonstration of unmanned flying skills. The president also met with MTSU students Ryan Baskett and Brett Bornhoff, who will be among the first in the university's aerospace program to take advantage of the new curriculum.
I'm also pleased that this announcement coincides with our plans for the center, creating the Center for Unmanned System Operational Advancement and Research at MTSU. This new center will provide a collaborative environment for academic, industry, and government entities.
The Army has flown over 1.3 million unmanned hours, what the Department of Defense calls the most disruptive technological change on the battlefield since the helicopter.
These systems save lives on the battlefield every day. I see it. These folks around this room see it. And I think you're going to see it, too, on the commercial side, just as you see it today. So
the commercial opportunities for unmanned aerial systems for search and rescue, spotting forest fires, and surveying agricultural land places MTSU on the leading edge of education and research in collaboration with the U.S. Army.
My number one priority was said, we need to have a relationship with the program office. Not only is it 2 hours away, but if there's anybody that is innovative and leading the charge on where the future of UAS is going, it's these guys.
As director of MTSU's Unmanned Aircraft Systems Operations, Kyle Snyder will help oversee Ravens like these, donated by the Army, to help MTSU develop the hands-on curriculum for the innovative technology. The first class begins this fall. Mike Browning, MTSU News.